Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. In today's video, we are going to review the new released model by Google, the Gemma 2, and we will do some tests using chain of truth prompts. This is one of the exercises that I used to do with the some of the models that the providers release, and I tested versus five different questions, all of them maths problems or problems where you need to apply some logic. I do that because I know that is some of the most difficult questions for models, LLMs, and then this way I had the choice to compare how the different models are responding to this question. So to start with, the model come with two versions, two sizes, 9 billions and 27 billions models. One of them is, and also there is two different, sorry, here is better to see it. We had two different size and two different versions, 9 billion, the base, the pre-trained model, and 9 billion is instruction tuned. This is a fine-tuned model in prompt instruction, and 27 billion identical base pre-trained and fine-tuned instructions in prompt instruction. So the model is available through different channels. You have to agree before using the terms of use, regardless through which channels you are going to use it. Here I'm showing you right now Google AI Studio, previously Google or Gemini AI Studio. Here you need to well to enroll to get a key. To get a key, just if you want to access programmatically through the Google AI Studio or through Vertex AI in Google Cloud. So also you can access through Kaggle and also through Hugging Face. We will review all of them later. So the first test I did it in Google AI Studio. In Google AI Studio, we only have the 27 versions instruction tuned. You see here the description. I will pass you later on the notebook that I will upload to the repository, all this documentation to you later on, review on your local environment. And again, we had two sizes, two versions, version model are trained to respond conversational input, and the pre-trained that is just not specialized in any specific task. So here we only had the 27, the biggest one, instruction tuned. And then I make the five questions with the four parameters, the five questions. Well, for those that are familiar or are members of the or subscribe to the channel, you probably saw some of the tests I did before, the same five questions. I did it with Mistral 7 billions, with Llama 2 7 billions, Llama 3 8 billions, also ChatGPT 3.5 Turbo, the 4, and also the 4.0. We also did it with Gemini 1.0, with Claude 3, Sonnet, and I don't remember the smaller and the biggest one. And also we did it with V3 Mini, the 3.8 billions, the smaller one, in the new model from Microsoft. And finally, we do it with Gemma. And then we did it as well with Gemini 1.0, 1.4, 1.5, and the latest version, the fast one. And for all those models, only the GPT-4, GPT-4o, Claude, Sonnet, if I'm not wrong, the biggest one, and Gemini Pro 1.5 Fast, and the previous one as well, and V3 answer correctly all the questions. The rest either fail in the last one, which is the more complex, or fail in some others as well. But the only ones so that answer correctly all of them, you will see now. Again, if you probably watch my videos, you will see all these tests in the others, and only the biggest ones answer the latest question correctly, together with the Microsoft Phi Mini. Surprisingly, the Phi 3 Mini answer it also all the questions correctly, without any. The model I used at that time was the 3.8 billions, the not quantified, and again answer correctly everything. Here, the Gemma 2 also answer the 27 millions, answer all the questions correctly. Here, just a very simple question. It's just I provide a list and I ask to do the calculations. Let me do it again down, just to, because here in the notebook I also include here another letter. And I think I include a number just to make it a little bit more complicated. And then you just hit the question. The model for this model, this size is state of the art model, is quite simple, this question. So even we have here, I just also compare the models, the 9 billion instruction TANET in the different benchmarks, with the Phi-3, and then on, surprisingly, the Phi-3 is beating the 9 billion models in some of the benchmarks, especially in those connected with like RCC, which is a chain of truth one, and also the, let me remember, RC TensorShot is 86.3, and also the Bitbank Hard 73.5. This is a chain of truth as well benchmark. And where is Bigsben? Chain of truth 68.2. So, and here even 74.9, the 27 billions. So just compare with the same benchmark in 73.5, but this model is 3.9 billions of parameters, which 74, 73. So this model is at the level in that specific benchmark. Some of them are even better, for sure better than the 9 billions, and also in this case, practically the same that the 27 billions, 1% less than the 27 billions. But again, well, in that case, it's just to make a comparison in between the different models. So this question was correct. Now I make another question. Here is another problem. All these problems are I make the same battery of questions to the models, and I only observe the response here as well. Is making or answering correctly. So the rationale is quite organized, the model, this size. So here the next one is so here is I bought an apples, I gave two to the neighbor and two to the repairman. Then I went again, I bought five and I ate one. Obviously we had 10, and then on the machine answer correctly. Here, when I was 6 years, my sister was half of my age. Now I'm 70 years old. What is the age of my sister now? 67. Correct, correct as well. I had a car 20 years ago, and at that time I was 37. How old I am now? 57. Correct. And now the depreciation calculation. I had a car 20 years ago, and it cost $100. The depreciation is 5%. Using the percentage declining balance, blah blah blah. And well, the answer is absolutely correct. So no problem here. The model behaved perfectly. So later we will see with the quantified versions, and there the history, and with the 9 billion model, and the situation is slightly different. So here, we had the possibility to use the models as well in Kaggle and also Vertex AI. You go to Kaggle. You can use here, you have different variants, different examples. It is pretty interesting. Gemma in C++. I will take a closer look to see how it works, and then probably I will prepare a video with just this. And also I want to see the GUF. Here you probably know you also had access to free infrastructure, free GPU. So well, you can take a look here and see if how it works. I don't see here code. There is people who is already working. Here you get my chatbot. I don't know. I will take a look how it works with C++. Quite interesting. Probably in the documentation. With Gemma CPP. Probably in this repository we have some. Okay. I will take a look and again. Probably I will create a video just for the C++ version. Then on, you can use it as well in Vertex AI. Vertex AI is where you had the biggest possibilities, no? You had a lot of options here. Also plenty of examples how to use it. Just to share predictions, you can fine-tune it as well. You have different examples. You have also access to different, in Kubernetes, GKE, and also how to work with different technologies, Keras 3, PyTorch, and distributed unit as well. And also the different versions. You had the 27 billions, the 9 billions, the 7 billions fine tune as well. Here we had a small version, a 2.2 version. This is pretty interesting, this one. Very small model. This is probably some other one as well I will try. But looking at those are the previous versions. This is Gemma 1. This is Gemma 1, the previous version, and this is Gemma 2. So well, this is those models are already, well, soon they will be deprecated by Google once they release this. So we had the code Gemma in 2 billions. This is also the variants, the code specialized versions of the Gemma version 1 and Pali Gemma 3B. All of these are the old versions or the previous versions of the Gemma. So, but well, in any case, you had access to the new versions also as well, Vertex AI. You can serve a model directly onto the In your Google Cloud, in the model garden, you have it available. You can deploy to an endpoint and immediately start to do predictions. You can deploy both 9 and 27 million. And also you had plenty of, you can do your experimentation in the enterprise collab. You can just simply, you just need to fill the boxes with the appropriate, how to say, URIs, like to your bucket. It's not, it will create something for you. Also from where you want to load it, the token, if you use Hugging Face, the it's just where they will download all the stuff, one of your buckets, you deploy to an entry point, etc. But well, it's pretty simple to use this because it's pretty limited what you can do at the end. It's just this kind of notebook provide you is a fully guided to you not just to fill the gaps or to fill the boxes, and that's it. It's pretty simple to use. So I didn't want it to do it here because obviously you need to create a runtime and then obviously have a cost, and then and it's pretty much very more expensive that to do it on Google Colab, where finally I did it. In Google you also had access, in Hugging Face, you had access to these four models. You had access as well to the previous versions of all the models that are in this series, but well, we are interested on that. You had the full documentation how to load it in different formats with flash attention, 4-bit precision, 8-bit precision, Pro 32, the original one, Brain Flow 16, etc. And well, I did the test with two versions, so I took the 9 billion IT. We are running this in a Colab Pro with an L4, 23, almost 23 gigabytes of memory. And here, well, just simply I tested with BrainFlow 16, a quantized model, and the same questions. So let's take a look to how the model answers. Here the model answered correctly to the question of summing up the list of the numbers in the list. That was correct. The problem with the apples was correct as well, 10 apples. The problem of the age of my sister, correct as well, 67 years old. The problem with the my age, looking at the age I had 20 years ago, correct as well, 57, and the problem of the deprecation, it was wrong. So even not close. Here, so the explanations was correct. Here, well, this is what you see. You can do your own test with this, remove the, change the temperature, whatever. But none of them, in any circumstances, give me the correct answer. I thought, well, maybe it's because it's quantized. Well, I tried with another quantization, 4 bits, and here I make the same exercise, but with the 4-bit precisions. 4-bit precision is answering everything correct. The summing up of the list, as well, 832 apples problem, 10 apples, also correct. The age of my sister, 67, correct. The my age, looking at my age when 20 years ago, correct. And also here, with the 4-bit version, is also answering incorrectly. The explanations that it provides are correct, but later on the calculations are wrong. So surprisingly, the answer that they it provides with the 4 bits precision is closer than the answer that the model provides in brain float 16. In any case, I cannot load, couldn't load in memory the version without quantization, and then it's really difficult now to get a A100 to load the model. But well, in summary, the model is really good, even that when the these questions are not correctly answered. But well, just consider that the model is how to say, I'm using the quantized versions. The model is small. It's true that the V3 answer this correctly. You can, again, you can take a look to the tutorial on the channel. But well, it's behaving very very similar, probably better than other models on the same size, no? Like the Llama 3, 8 billions, and Mistral 7 billions. It's a little bit bigger than those, but the behavior is very, very similar to the other one, very fast as well, and also these quantized versions are not losing quality. So this model, for example, is running very fast in this quantized version, is using practically no memory. Not practically no memory, but not many memory. And when you get an answer with the good quality and fast, no? Which is probably the purpose of Google. Pretty much is that. From my point of view, the test is quite satisfactory. I want to test a little bit more, but again, I will do it with in another video. I want to test with the C++ version and the GGUF as well, and see the quality as well of these quantizations. And I will try to test the model as well without quantization at in this size to check it the final question, the complex the most complex problem is being solved correctly by this version. I guess probably even here we are doing zero shot prompting, which is really hard for models to answer these questions, even when they are well trained and state of the art, whatever. But yeah, but for that reason I do these kind of questions to the models, just to test if there is every day are closer and better. Again, the example is the V3, it's answering correctly everything. But probably they fine-tune the model, because this is an Strat model as well. They fine-tune it with this purpose, no? Or probably with more focus in COT than in other tags. That's why the numbers in this kind of tags on the benchmarks are higher than in any other, even bigger model, biggest model, bigger models, exactly. Well, that's all. Thank you very much for watching the video up to this point. I hope you like it, you find it interesting, and it was useful for you, or for your training, for your job, or whatever reason you are watching this video. And well, that's all. Give me a like if that's the case, if you like the video. Subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before, and share with your friends and colleagues to help me to promote the channel in YouTube. Thank you very much. See you soon.